In today's video, we're going to go through the ActiveRecord events gem, and it is such a good, useful gem. It is ultimately a massive time saver. I'm going to show you how to set it up. I'm going to show you how it works, and you're going to come out of it being just like, ugh, how did I survive without this gem? It is a real good one to have in your toolkit. The ActiveRecord events gem, we use it to manage timestamps. And you're probably wondering, well, why do I care? How does this affect me? Well, the problem we're trying to solve is it's a really good pattern to store Boolean fields as date times. The reason for this is a Boolean could be nil, false, or true. A date time is only ever going to be nil or the date it was set. And the extra bit of free information we get is we know exactly when that field was set to true, which is a lot better than like a true or false. The only caveat is we end up having to write methods like this, where maybe we have to check if it's present. We might have to write a method to kind of nicely set that using good domain logic. We may even create one method and without making its like partner method. So if this started method here, I never made a bang. So if I was to maybe play around with it in the console, or someone else was, they might get a bit annoyed at it because they're like, I expect this method to be there because this other one is there. Why isn't it there? So this gem, what it will do is it gives us this little helper method called hasEvent, and then it will go off and create like methods and scopes and class methods matching that name. So in this case, we get like completed question mark to see is this instant completed. We also get like a little bang method to say, okay, let's complete this method. Let's set that value. We also get a little class method to say, okay, let's complete all these tasks, which is very handy for scopes. Lastly, we get some scopes, which will return a collection when we can scope that if we want, or where that field is present or not present. And that's really handy if you just want to quickly pull up a list of objects, for example. Before we start, I'd just like to remind you to smash that like button, add a little comment, and subscribe to my channel. It makes such a big difference and helps me so much. Let's get to it. We're going to add the gem to our gem file by running bundle add ActiveRecord events. And when we run this, what it's going to do is append it to our gem file and then install the gem. So we can see it doing its thing now. And if we go to here, you can see it's just been added, which is quite cool. So the next thing we want to do is we want to add a field to this task model called completed at. And we could write a normal migration where we do Rails DB or Rails generate migration and then add some stuff in there. However, this has a really handy little helper in here, where we're going to be able to just say, like, pass it some arguments and it's going to generate it for us. And it's this one here. So if I do Rails G active record event, and we're going to pass it the model name and then the field name. And that's going to just go off and make our migration file for us and also append some magic to the model. So we have that there now. So let's have a quick look at this. Let's see what this migration looks like. Great. Yeah, so we could have made that ourselves, but it's quite nice to have something generate it for us. So I'm just going to pull that over. And now we're going to run Rails DB migrate to make sure we've got that there. Good stuff. So now that's all added to our database. So let's have a look at what this looks like. So let's do task equals task dot first. And there we have a task. And it has completed that and that equals nil. So let's do completed. Okay. So the first task we have in our database is currently not complete. So if we do complete bang, it will now mark it as complete. Yeah, it's now returning true. So that's quite cool. So what if we wanted to have a quick look at all of our models? So we've got about three in there. Only one of them is actually completed. So if we were to do not completed, there we go, we just get two. So if I do count, there we go. However, if you wanted to pull up just the completed stuff, you can call just completed, which is nice. And we could probably also use the scope method, which I believe is complete all. So now if we do task.all, you can see it's now marked them all as completed. That's really handy. That is the end of this video. I'm hoping you found that useful and enjoyable. I am Mike Rogers Zero on Twitter. If you have any questions, feel free to send me a message or drop a little comment underneath this video. Thank you for watching, and I will catch you next time.